Gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who has given the ability to perform Ramadan, to fasting, to make sure sahur, to make sure breakfasting, to participate Taraweeh, to participate Tezkirah and other prayers. Now, today is a closing or last day of Taraweeh as well as our Tezkirah. My subject topic was Islamisation of education and knowledge in the modern world. I tried to convey the message regarding the topic. Two things: the modern world and importance, a characteristic of Islamization of knowledge and education. This is two main things. I said the modern world, there is a world where we are living. This world does not recognize the position of Tawheed, the role of Allah, role of prophets. This modern world, particularly its education, its knowledge paradigm, its system of modern educational system, eliminated all kind of influence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the educational process, intellectual process, cultural process, even our daily life. We are Muslim, but our majority part of life is not actually related with Islamic principle, with the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is a main characteristic from the Islamic point of view about modern world. Modern world has a lots of success about materialistic interest. Modern world, with the lead by Western world, they produce, they establish lots of technological, scientific and other facilities for whole humanity. But unfortunately, they very consciously, very intentionally, they remove, they ignore, they destroy the Islamic position, Tawhidic position, religious position in the life, in the culture, in the civilization, in the educational process. That is a problem from the Islamic point of view. In this perspective, the many Muslims are living around the world with the influence of Western education, Western culture, Western paradigm of knowledge. They felt that our faith in Islam is not influential, not important to the education. Thus, Muslims are becoming atheists, modernist, liberalist. There are lots of terminology. Main things, modernist. The majority of the modernists are living, or are living out of Islamic principle, Islamic life. They found it is a main cause, related with the root cause of problem, crisis in the Muslim education, which is actually, which was resulted by the modern world. In this perspective, Muslim scholar tried to introduce new kind of education, it's called Islamic education, from the original heritage, original tradition of Muslim from the first. They found the Muslim countries are following education, sometimes Islamic studies, but this is, that was not completely fulfilled the demand of direction of Islam. It was totally partial. Then they said, no, we have to reconstruct, reform, restructure our own education with the Quranic epistemology, Quranic paradigm, Quranic knowledge, Islamic knowledge, philosophy of Islamic principle. Main core point, the Quranic paradigm of knowledge, which actually came through our beloved Prophet Hazrat Muhammad Mustafa Sallam, who introduced this revelation, this order to us. In this perspective, in that perspective, some Muslim scholars from Malaysia, from Pakistan, from Bangladesh, from Iran, from Philistine, work to introduce the new kind of Islamic education towards in the Muslim world. Among them, one of the very famous prominent personality from the Malaysia is Sayyid Muhammad Naqib al-Attas, who was a fortunately founder of this institute. Personally, I regard him as a Plato of our time. His outstanding scholarship made serious, tremendous impact around the world on behalf of Islamic thought. Secondly, late Ismail Azil Faruqi from Philistine, he contributed lots to introduce, to implement Islamization knowledge. Thirdly, late Professor Sayyid Ali Ashraf from Bangladesh, my mentors, who founded an university in Bangladesh where I work, and I am writing thesis on his contribution, is the contribution of Sayyid Ali Ashraf to the Islamization of education. He was one of the founder, he was a secretary general of the First World Conference of Muslim Education, and many others like Abul Hasan al-Nadbi from India and Pakistan, Fuzlur Rahman Ansari from Pakistan, many Muslim scholars worked and contributed to introduce, to implement the Islamization of knowledge and education in the conceptual manner. So what was the main tone of the conceptual form? Just I would like to focus on point. The Quranic concept of man, Islamic concept of man. In the light of Quranic concept of man, man is bound to act in the earth as a Khalifatullah. Means vice reason, representative of Allah. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created Hazrat Adam as a first man, that time man was committed to Allah, that I am going to earth to represent you. Allah clearly told the man that I am creating you to worship me and to act my representative in the earth. Are you ready? Man made a covenant, the commitment. Yes, I am ready, I am going to. So Islamizational knowledge and education trying to remind the scholar, the man, to introduce, to implement that concept of man which is related to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's first stage of creation of humanity. During that time, some issues was created by man between Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One is knowledge, learning, education. Man received knowledge from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is mentioned in the 31st ayat of Surah Baqarah. Meaning Allah taught all the names to Adam. We have to explore the meaning, hidden meaning of that names. This is a main core point of Islamization of knowledge in education to introduce in the educational process. If we will work to make success within the educational form, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be happy to us, and we can say that we have done our duty as a Khalifatullah in the earth. Thank you very much.